Hey guys, Rob Borden here again to talk to you about the Blue Collar Build-Off. I just wanted to go over a couple of questions that I've gotten from talking to a few of you guys on the phone, some comments that I've seen posted online on some of the stuff that we've done. So I just want to address a few questions that have come up and let everybody know. One question I got was, what kind of bike is accepted into the build? A guy asked if they could build a bagger. I really don't care what you build, man. As long as you build it within the budget, within the time frame, within all the other parameters of the build-off, you can build anything you want. I don't care if it's a sport bike, a fucking dirt bike, a bagger, cruiser, whatever, man. So all bikes are welcome to enter the build-off. Again, you just have to follow the same parameters that everybody else is following. Got a question about shops. Are shops able to enter? So little, small, independent, mom and pop shops, little local shops, that's fine. What we don't want is any big name shops that have, multi-million dollars of CNC machines and frame builders and fucking frame benders and exhaust benders and just all this fucking just crazy equipment that your average guy just wouldn't have. Again, this is a low budget build off. It's for average builders, average know-how, average tools. And most of your small, local, independent shops don't have much more than what an average home builder, has access to anyway, I'll put it that way. Your home builder, a lot of times they're gonna have a welder, they're gonna have different shit like that. So as long as it's a small little locally independent shop, something like that, it's fine. The only advantage that I see to a small private shop over just a guy in his own garage is just that the small little shop, they might have a few more parts laying around than a guy in his garage. So they might have extra fucking turn signals or handlebars or whatever. And that's fine too, because what's going to win this competition is not what you bolt onto the fucking bike. It's what you made. It's what you created, okay, out of nothing. And not to mention, I've known some home builders out there that are a lot better fucking builders and fabricators and everything else than people that own some of these small shops anyway, so I don't see any advantage that a small local shop like that would have over a home builder anyway, so that's fine. Just no big, major, big name, corporate sponsored fucking shops, none of that. I get a question about, what if one of the teams, the guy's a badass welder? Well, good for him, man. That's just one of his skill sets that he's bringing to the table, I'm not going to fucking count that against anybody because the guy's a fucking welder. Maybe he's going to cut up and stretch and rake a fucking frame and do something awesome with it. Again, that's just one of the skill sets that he brings to the fucking table. Same thing with a painter. We might have, some teams registered where one guy's a painter and he might lay down a fucking sick paint job. As long as they do it within the allotted $1,500 that you have, that you're able to spend on all of your supplies, materials, parts, and all that, then that's fine too. Another question I've been getting is about the donor bike. What do I expect you guys to start off with in terms of a donor bike? I really don't give a fuck what you start off with is a donor bike. I don't care if it's a complete donor bike that's running. I don't care if it's a donor bike that's been sitting around for 10 years and hadn't been started. I don't care if it's just a pile of fucking parts or less. I mean, one of the guys that submitted is Nate Mims out of Des Moines, Iowa, I think it is. Oh, I'm sorry. No, Nate is in Nebraska. My bad. So anyway, in his video, if you guys have seen that, his submission video, all he's starting off with is a fucking motor, and he shows you in the video, it's just a fucking motor he picked up for $100 for a Yamaha V-Star 1100, and that's what he's starting with. So that's his donor right there. On the other end of that spectrum, I got Jeremy Lehman that's submitted to hopefully get picked. And he's starting off with a complete late 80s, I think it is, or maybe early 90s Harley FXR. And in the video, it looks like it's a complete bike. Matter of fact, I even called him up and I'm like, hey, Jeremy, what the fuck, man? You got a complete bike already that looks like it's running and everything. Please tell me you don't plan on just fucking painting this motherfucker and throwing some fresh gas in it and calling it a day. And I stayed on the phone with him for about a half an hour, man. And he told me this list of shit that he wants to do to this bike. Extending the front end, building a custom swing arm for it, some tank work that he's got, and some other shit that, little, you know, shit that he's going to do to it. So, you know, hey, that's fine too, as long as you're going to do something with it. Because at the end, what I'm looking for, and I'm not going to be, you know, the only judge, but as far as what I have in mind on this competition, what I'm looking for is what you ended up with versus what you started with. So for instance, Jeremy, I know, and America is going to know, that he started off with pretty much a complete running fucking bike. So Jeremy had better fucking bring it when it comes to everything else. It better be one badass, custom, every fucking thing bike. Because he had a running bike when he started, or at least it looks running. It's complete anyway. As opposed to Nate, who started off with a fucking engine. So when I'm looking at Nate's bike, I know that Nate started off with just a fucking engine. And everything around that engine, he did. So when I look at Jeremy's bike, I'm going to look a little fucking closer. Because I want to see what fucking Jeremy did, right? So again, it's not about what you started off with. It's about what you ended up with and what you did to it to make it unique, okay? So, let's see. So like when it comes to that, for example, you know, I'm not looking for a nice, you know, shiny fucking Harley and the guy put a really pretty little fucking chrome Harley gas cap Willie G edition on that motherfucker. That's not what this build-off is about for me. For me, the build-off is about the guy that made his own fucking gas cap out of a fucking beer can and a fly swatter. What the fuck ever, dude? How creative did you get? What did you put into that bike? And how is it now as opposed to what it started off looking like? And that's it. So, last thing I want to address is the timeline. Talking to some of you guys on the phone and again some comments and just kind of putting the timeline together in my mind, I realize that some of you guys are going to be coming from pretty far away to go to the Las Vegas sign. So I can't have you building the bike up to March 30th and then expect you to be at the Las Vegas sign on March 31st. For some of the guys, that's just not going to happen. You got 2 or 3 days of travel time. So we're going to move up the build time a little bit to accommodate for people that are coming from farther away. I got people registering from the East Coast, and so it might take them a few days to get here. So, that being said, you're going to see me start changing shit on the internet and flyers and everything else, showing that the build time is now going to be from February 26th through March 27th. So there's your 30 days, February 26th to March 27th. That gives the guys plenty of time to get here and be at the Las Vegas sign, ready to roll. On March 31st, we'll head down to the Saddle Sore Ranch, which is just outside of Kingman, Arizona. We'll be rolling in right in the middle of the West Coast Rendezvous, which is an event that's going to be going on down there at the time. And that's where we'll have the final judging and awards and ceremony and fucking after party. And it's West Coast Rendezvous is basically a 3-day camp out party. It goes on from Friday through Sunday. It's an old school biker camp out party. So you guys will be rolling in with your bikes on the Saturday of that event. Of course, you're welcome to fucking hang out and party all night and camp out to the next day and go from there. But that's all I got for this time, man. I'll see you next time.